Now we are going to take up the one more problem. Find the reactions at the fixed end and draw the SFD and BMD for the cantilever beam loaded as shown in the figure. First, we will take up the cantilever beam. Which is one end is fixed, having a point, having the loads at this point E. We have a couple which is acting at this, which is then we have a UDL from here to here. So the points are, I will mark this point as A and I will mark this point as B and this point is C and this point is D and we have the point E and we have the point F. So the loads acting are 15 kilonewton and then we have 20 kilonewton meter, which is the couple, that is force into perpendicular distance. Then we have 20 kilonewton meter here, kilonewton per meter run, that is because it is UDL. So now the loads are acting at a distances of 0.5 meters, then we have again 0.5 meters, all are at 0.5 meters. So now we need to find out the vertical reaction, which is the upward force, the reactive upward force, and then the horizontal force and the entire thing with a moment. So here we will be having RAV, RAH, and this is MA. So these are the different forces or the reactive reactions and the couples which are going to act. Now first we are going to find out the reactions. Now to find out the reactions at the support, to find the reactions at the support, the first reaction is the horizontal force. Sigma H will be equal to 0 as there is no horizontal load acting on the beam, so RAH will be equal to 0. Then we want to consider the vertical reaction. Sigma VV is equal to 0. The load which is acting upwards is considered to be positive. So in such a case, in that case, we will going to have this here, RAV, which is acting upwards, which will be equal to MA minus 20 into 0.5, then 15, because the couple is not to be considered. Couple is considered only for the bending moment. For the shear force, it is only the load which is acting on the beam which should be considered. So in that case, it is 20 kilonewton per meter. So you have 0.5, 20 into 0.5 will going to become 10 plus 15 will going to be the value. So now here we have MA minus 20 into 2, 20 into 0.5, minus 20 into 0.5 and minus 15, which is equal to 0. Therefore, the value of MA will be equal to 25 kilonewton. So here, this is the value of, this is the value of RAV, which should be, RAV will be equal to, this is RAV, that is the vertical reaction. This is the vertical reaction. RAV will be equal to 25 kilonewton. Now, The next is the moment, that is sigma m, will be equal to 0. So sigma m will be equal to 0. Always the clockwise moment is considered to be positive. So that will be taking the moments about the point A. Taking the moments about the point A. About A, which is MA, which is minus MA, will be equal to. So here, coming to this, we have taking the moments, that is minus MA, because it is counterclockwise, the clockwise is positive, minus MA, then plus 20 into 0.5 into 0.5 by 2 plus 0.5, then minus 20 plus 20 and minus 15, that is plus 15 into 2. So that will be equal to minus MA again plus 20 into 0.5 into 0.5 by 2 plus 0.5 plus 20 plus 15 into 2. So this will going to be the value. So to find that, it will be minus MA plus 20 into 0.5 into 0.5 by 2 plus 0.5, then clockwise couple again plus 20 plus 15 into 2 will be equal to 0. Therefore, MA will be equal to 20 into 0.5, which will be 10, into 0.5, 0.25, it will be 0.75, plus 20, plus 30. So that will be, therefore, MA will be equal to 57 point. So it will be 30, 50, plus 7.5, which will be 57.5 kilo Newton meter. So this will be the value. So that will be equal to, so since it is the reactive moment, so it will going to be the counterclockwise direction. So the value what you will going to get here will be RAV will be equal to, so it is 1025 Newton. RAH will be equal to 0 and MA will be equal to 57.5 kilo Newton meter. Now we will find out the shear force diagram, and the bending moment diagram. To find out the shear force and the bending moment diagram, the first we will extend this for all the points. From each points we will going to extend so the first will going to be the shear force, which is at F. As there is no force is acting on the member at this point F, SF will be 0. So here, so first we are going to take up the shear force diagram. Shear force diagram, that is SFD. So SF at the point F will be equal to SF at the point F. Point F will be equal to 0. Similarly, between F and E, SF is 0. Because it is a constant, so we will not be able to get it. So that means as there is no load which is coming between these two, SF at this point, it is again 0. So at this point is 0. as there is no load between A and F, it will be 0. Here also it becomes 0. Then SF at E will be equal to plus 15 kilonewton. So at this point we will going to have plus 15 kilonewton. So SF at F will be equal to SF at E will be equal to plus 15 kilonewton. Then here between D and E, there is no load which is acting, so it will remain the same. And again, between C and D also there is no load because the couple is not considered when you are considering the shear force. So it will going to remain the same till at this point. So here, as we are considering this, so SF at between E and D, between capital E and D, SF is constant at 15 kilonewton. Then again SF at D, again plus 15 kilonewton. Then as we know, between C and D also, between D and C also, there is no load which is acting on the member, so it will be constant 15. So here SF at D, between D and C, SF is constant at 15 kilonewton. Then SF at C, so when you are considering SF at C, so at this point also, which will be 15 kilonewton. So here it will be 15 kilonewton. Then SF at C will be equal to plus, that is, will be equal to plus 15 kilonewton. Then SF at B will be equal to plus 15 and plus 15 and 20 into 0.5, plus 20 into 0.5, which will be again 10, so it will be 25 kilonewton. So between C and B, SF varies linearly. Why? Because it is of the form of W into X, where the power of X will be equal to 1. So therefore, it will have a linear line. It will be a linear line. So it becomes varies linearly because of the UDL. So now, between SF at B will be equal to 25 kilonewton. So between C and B, SF varies linearly from plus 15 kilonewton to plus 25 kilonewton due to UDL. So here, so this is the equation what you will going to get. So from here to here, if you are considering, so from this point to this point, it will be 25 kilonewton. So then join between these two with a linear line. So this point will going to be variation is linear. So between A and B, again it remains constant, which will be 25 kilonewton here. So this is how you will be able to get the shear force diagram. So at this point, due to your between B and A, between capital B and A, SF is constant. SF is constant at 25 kilonewton. Then SF at A will be equal to plus 25 kilonewton. Now, similarly, now we will going to see this at this point. So this is how you will going to have the variation of the shear force diagram at each point and each load. So this will going to be the SFD. Now we will going to consider the bending moment diagram. So this will be the variation of load for each member at the each point due to the application of load. So now when we are considering the bending moment diagram, first we will write the bending moment diagram. Bending moment diagram. So here this will be BMD, which is the load which is acting in this direction, it will be negative. So first point, when we are considering BM at F will be equal to zero. So as we are considering the bending moment here, the BM at this point BM at F will be equal to zero. Then BM at E is also equal to zero. BM at E will also be equal to zero. So in both the cases here, BM at F, bending moment at F will be equal to zero. Then BM at E will be equal to zero. Then BM at D we will going to consider now. So when you are considering at BM at D will be minus 20 kilonewton into, so here at this point we have the two loads which are coming between this. BM at D on the right hand portion, when you are considering that BM at D at the right hand portion, so now when the load is acting at this point, so now we will try to explain how it will going to be considered at BM at D. So the BM at D, when we are considering, there are two loads which is acting at this point. One is at F and the other one is this point will be, which is 15 kilonewton, which is E. And here at D, there are, one is the couple which will going to be acting at this point. Now BM at D on the right hand portion, BM at D on the right hand portion, right hand portion, which will be equal to MDR. So the load which is acting at this point, which will be 0.5 meters, and here also it is 0.5 meters, and which will be minus 15 into 0.5, that will be equal to minus 7.5 kilonewton meter. So on the right hand portion, which will be at this point, the load will be 7.5 kilonewton meter. Next, when you are coming to the left hand portion of this, so here the load, what the couple which is acting here, which will be 20 kilo Newton meter. So MD on the left hand side of the portion, which will be -7.5 and -20, which will be equal to -27.5 kilo Newton meter. Only this case will going to be arised only when you have the two loads which are acting at that particular point. So here, so since the couple is acting only at this point, so the couple is already, which is to force into the perpendicular distance. So that is the consideration. If it is, if only the load is there, then at BM or D will going to be zero. But since you are considering the couple, it is already given with the force into the distance. So that is why you are going to get -27.5 kilo Newton. So at this point, we will be having 27.5 kilo Newton meter. So now at this point it is 7.5, and the next condition here is BM at C. When you are considering at BM at C, so BM at C is, so now -15 into 1 -20, so it will be 35 kilo Newton meter. So to do that, so BM bending moment BM at C will be equal to, so now when we are considering at C, the loads which are acting on this, which is F here, then one point is at E, which is the load which is acting vertically down, and we have a couple here, then we have the point C at this point. So all the loads are at the distances of 0.5 meters between each of them. So this is 0.5, this is 0.5, and this is 0.5. So here this is 15 kilo Newton and this is 20 kilo Newton meter. So BM at C will be equal to -15 into 1 and -20, which will be MC, will be equal to -35 kilo Newton meter. So at this point, -35 kilo Newton meter. So again, which is a linear curve, so it is from here to here, it is a linear line. Again from here to here, it is a dark line, and again it is a linear line. And now then we'll come to this next BM at B, which we need to consider here. BM at B, so once you are considering the BM at B, so the condition will be having the UDL now also into the consideration. So when you are considering the UDL, now BM at B, now BM at B, which will be MB, so the condition is, now we have the loads which are acting at this point, which is F. Then we have a point load, which is 15 kilo Newton. Then we have a couple, which is 20 kilo Newton meter. Then we have point C. Then we have the load, which is the UDL, which is B. So this will be 20 kilo Newton meter per meter. So all the distances will be equal to 0.5 meters between them. So the points are, this is 0.5 meters, this is 0.5 meters, and this is 0.5 meters, and this is 0.5. So that will be, MB will be equal to -15 into 1.5, -20, minus 20 into 0.5 into 0.5 by 2. So the overall will be equal to minus then BM at B will be equal to minus 15 into 1.5 minus 20 minus 20 into 0.5 into 0.5. So that will be equal to minus 45 kilo Newton meter. Since it is, this is of the form of W into X into X by 2. So it is, the order of this is square. So you will going to have a parabolic curve. So the one which we're going to get here will be a parabolic curve from here to here. So we will going to get 45 kilo Newton meter, which will going to be the parabolic curve. So from here to here it will be parabolic. So this will be a parabolic curve, and from here the last is the bending moment at the point A, which will going to be 57.5. so from here to here again it is a linear curve. You will going to get this point, which will be 57.5 kilo Newton meter. So this is how you will be able to, so this is how you will be able to write the bending moment diagram. So to check the value at the bending moment at the point A, so first is we will going to consider the load which is acting from the point 15 kilonewton into 2 minus 15 into 2 minus 20 minus 20 into 0.5 into 0.5 by 2 plus 0.5. so we will going to write that equation. Now the bending moment at the point A, BM at A, which will be equal to MA. So we'll get minus 15 into 2 minus 20 minus 20 into 0.5, sorry, minus 20 minus 20 into 0.5 minus 20 into 0.5, okay, minus 20 into 0.5 into 0.5 by 2 plus 0.5. so this is how you will going to get this. Therefore the value of MA, which will be equal to minus 57.5 kilo Newton meter. So this will going to be the final answer, where the bending moment is linear between B and A. So here the value is the nature of the curve, what you are going to get, which will going to be the linear. Here also the variation is a linear between C and D, and here also the variation is linear. So this is how you will be able to write the bending moment diagram.